Hello and welcome. This is Reverend Raymond from the Living and Holiness Chapel of the Lord's House of Prayer Intercessory Ministries. Praise the Lord. Our mission is to win souls for our great Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, we need to win the souls for Him and pray Him so they can live eternity with our God. Did you know God loves you? He always has, He always will. He offers you eternal life. Thank you, Jesus, for eternity and life. Praise the Lord. Yes. Today, I want to invite you to study your Bible today. Study the Word of Jesus Christ. I will tell you truthfully, it is now 3 a.m. in the morning, and praise the Lord, He woke me up to tell you this. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. We are in the end of days. Everything that this Bible, that's in it, has told us, tells us what's going to happen in the last days of our lives. If you don't know Jesus, you're going to have a hard time living eternity without Him. My wish, dreams, and desires to have Him in my life, so I make sure that I have eternity with my Lord Jesus Christ. So, why don't you say out loud today with me, and we'll get this to started on the next chapter of our lives the rest of this year. We need to work on saying this on a constant basis. As I work on it, I hope you work on it too. And follow me to stay out loud with me. I won't let go until you bless me, Lord. I won't settle for less, Lord. The Bible says it, I believe it, and that settles it, Lord. I am who God says I am. I can do what God says I can do. I can have what God says I can have. I am a child of the most beloved High God. If He said it, it surely will come to pass. Folks, that last passage I just read there, so I ask you to say with me. Let's examine that a little bit better. Praise the Lord. He says, I am, God says, who I am. You know, in Genesis, He says, let us make man in our own image. So, what do you mean by let us make man in our own image? He's wanting us to give Him the praises of who we are in our lives, to give Him thanks, not ourselves, not what we want, but what God wants. He wanted people to have a soul to choose freely, so we can freely give Him thanks for what we truly have in our lives. I can do what He says I can do. His Word says that He is the truth. His Word is not a lie. His Word stands firm all these years. So, therefore, whatever He says I can do, all I gotta do is go to His Word, and it will happen. I can have what He says I can have. One of the chapters, Matthew 7:7, ask and ye shall receive, seek and ye shall find, knock, and the door shall open unto you. He says we can have it. All we gotta do is ask for it, seek out what we're looking for, knocking on the door, and he shall open the door so us to have it. I am a child of the Most High, beloved God. If you have Jesus in your life, you are a child of God. You've accepted him, so now you belong to his family, so that would make you his child. If he said it, and his word says, I am that I am, so he said it, it surely will come to pass. See, God didn't make this world to come to pass because he didn't say it. He said it, so it surely came to pass. Just as he said it, man came to pass. So, that's basically what that is all about. I want to thank you, Lord, for that opportunity to say this out loud. Let's bow our heads. Father, we come in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for all the things you've done for us. We thank you for your opportunities to extend your hand to us, to give us a blessing from you, a twofold blessing. We know that your hand is in our future. We know that you're working things to favor us because we are your children of the most beloved high God that we serve. As we serve you, Lord, as we thank you, as we worship you, we ask you in the name of Jesus, his name above all names, to give us the ability to walk in your word as we open your word and to live that word which is true in our hearts. We ask you, Lord, to cultivate us like a farmer, Lord, till our grounds, put the seed of the word in us, so we might be cultivated and then flourished with the living word of the water of the blood of Jesus. Or we might be able to grow with the Holy Spirit. I want to thank you. I want to thank you in the name of Jesus. We pray, amen and amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. You know, as I was saying, this is the end of times. And Revelations, there is so much that people want to say, well, wait a minute, I don't want to believe in that, I don't want to hear that. They want to sugarcoat the water down of the Bible. Unless you know the truth, and the truth is right here, you know, you ain't going to know the truth. And so I say to you is this, if you don't want to have a relationship, then expect yourself to be ready to not have an eternity relationship with him. But if you want eternity, a relationship with him, you need to spend more time and quality time with him. How do you do that? Well, there are many people who have many ideas and suggestions on how to do this. And here's my suggestion. First off, get into the Bible and read it. Spend some time. Read the passage that you're reading, whatever that passage is. Once you've got it read, ponder on that for a minute. Think about what the words say and what does it mean. After you've done that, spend a minute and ask God to come into your heart and to be able to saturate the word that you had just read into your heart to where you're able to understand Him and hear Him and listen to His voice with reasonings of His Word. Yes, thank you, Jesus, for all that you are in our lives. I have so much that I have to say, so little time on this earth to say it. You know, I'm not the only one in this earth that preaches. There are a lot of people out there that preach. Some are better than others, but that's okay. But God has a calling for those who really want to have a calling. The calling to extend themselves out to help others in their need of the Word of God, to give them the pure nourishment that they need right here. Some people sugarcoat it. And it's like, well, I'm going to sugarcoat it because I'm afraid that somebody's going to be offended. There it is right there. A word I've been looking for, offended. If I offend you in any way, shape, or form, I pray to you that you talk to the Heavenly Father, talking to the man upstairs, and say, look, I got a problem with this. Don't chastise me. Don't judge me. You don't know me. But only God does. He says we're supposed to love one another. But we as ministers or pastors or preachers, praise the Lord, we give ourselves devotions to you all. We tell you the truth. When you tell us to sugarcoat it, and praise the Lord, it's kind of hard to sugarcoat something the truth if you're not going to want to listen to it. Don't listen to it. No, I'm going to be honest with you. I was in my teens. I did the exact same thing. I just didn't want to listen to it. So I just kind of closed my ears. But, you know, it's just... It's just the way it, Lord, I don't know who out there needs you, but I know there's somebody out there, and I feel it, you're really needing somebody to pray for you. So, Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus. I ask you to extend your holy hand upon that person. Touch them. The blessings of your hands. Like a farmer, Lord, cultivate them. Plant your seed in them. Flourish them. And water them down with the saturated of the blood of Jesus Christ, for they might be able to walk with you. If you don't have Jesus in your heart, it may be too late. So I pray in the name of Jesus that somehow, some way, that you open your heart, you open your mind to Jesus. I know that there are a lot of things that I have that I don't know how to. I am not the great big preacher, the great big pastor. I'm not the Joe Osteen, Joyce Myers, Billy Graham style type person who can stand there and, you know, tell you, hey, this is the way it is. But if you're going to live for God, I have four simple steps that I think that is very important, that if you're going to live for Jesus, It's a life that you can imagine. The first step is to follow God's lead. Be sensitive to the Spirit as He prompts and gently leads you to a place of joy. Be sensitive to the Holy Spirit as He prompts and gives you a place of joy. My second suggestion to you is be quick to forgive. Don't harbor any bitterness in your life. Bitterness eats you alive. Joy and peace are restored to you in your life when you learn how to forgive and forget. Those go together. Those two things go together. Joy and peace can be restored in your life once you start forgiving. Number three, refuse to complicate simple issues. So much often in our lives, we try to complicate the system of our lives. Living with a complicated lifestyle will steal your joy. Simplicity will bring power and peace. Accept the simplicity that is yours in Christ. People, depends on how you live. If you live with a negative attitude, you're going to have a negative life. You live with a positive attitude, you can have a positive life. But with God, of course, that you got to have in your life. My last fourth statement of this would be, live in contentment. Be content with what you have and be the person God made you. God didn't design you to be Oral Roberts. God didn't design you to be that great sports player that many are out there. God didn't design you to be somebody else. He designed you to be specifically you and you only. He designed you so you can have joy at the level so you can prove yourself dramatically. So be content with who you are. So the four things I suggest that you would have to live your way with Jesus in your life is to follow God's leading, be quick to forgive, refuse to complicate simple issues, and live in the contentment. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for these four ways that you've given us opportunities to learn to live in our lives, to have you as Christ in our lives. We thank you, Lord, for your opportunity to cultivate us, flourish us, guide us, strengthen us. Holy Spirit, come into our hearts. Teach us. Teach us your word. Convict our hearts when we do wrong. For we know that when we do wrong, we can ask for forgiveness. People, when you ask God for forgiveness, remember, go back to my number two step, be quick to forgive. Forgive others. That way it won't be saturated. Your Father cannot forgive you if you don't forgive others. How can He forgive you if you harboring a resentment against somebody else? So, be quick to forgive, and He will forgive. His Bible says, I forget, no. I don't know what sin you had. Once I forgive you, that's it. I don't remember them. I remember them no more. So, that sin, he forgives you. He don't remember it. You won't be held accountable for that sin. But now, I'll say to you, if you ask for forgiveness and he forgives you, you need to work on that forgiveness. You need to work on that particular issue that you are working on and not trying to do it again. Yet, lest your father forgives you, but yet you turn around and do the same thing over again, how in the world could he forgive you over and over and over? Eventually, he's going to say, I'm sorry, I can't do that anymore. He's just like a parent. He's our parent. He's our father. He will punish us to wake us up to say, wait a minute, I know I've been sinning, and now I'm going to have to get out of that. So thank you, for Jesus, for the opportunity. Father, we thank you for this opportunity that you've given in our hearts. Friends, if you don't know Jesus, you're not going to have eternity with him. If you want eternity with him, you need to give yourself totally to Jesus. I wish you would go back to Jesus today. I never go back. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. Stuff is great. We thank you, Lord, for waking me up and doing this. Don't go back to your sinful life again. Walk in his word. Walk in his precious word. In the name of Jesus. Because tomorrow might be the last day in your life. You may not have a chance after that. And then you'll be eternally without God. You know, the Bible says that hell, people will be gnashing their teeth and be the hell of flames. It also said that every disease, every sickness, and everything that you have incurred in your lifetime will be put on you in hell. Every curse that you curse somebody will curse back on you. Everything that you do, it would be over and over and over, and there'll be no stopping. You know, hell is not talked very often about recently about the Bible. But to me, hell is a place where people are going to be wishing that they had changed their lives or not getting an opportunity to change because they refuse to change. So if you want Jesus in your life today, say this simple prayer with me. That way we can get you started. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I come to you as a sinner. I have mercy upon me, Lord Jesus. I believe you died for my sinful life and was raised on the third day. Lord Jesus, I've made up my mind to serve you with all my heart. Never go back to my sinful life again. Lord Jesus, send down your Holy Spirit and direct all my paths. I believe I'm a new person with a new beginning in Christ. Lord Jesus, come to my life today. Let me have you in my heart today. Let me place you in my heart to where you could stay to gift me the cultivating the flourishing of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus, for coming into my life. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I say to you, Lord, people, Lord, if they've said this prayer, and if you've truly meant this prayer with all your heart, all your mind, the soul that's up here, I pray that Jesus comes into your heart and changes your life. So may God bless you, and may you find a church that helps you grow in your relationship with Jesus Christ. We're very pleased today that you've chosen to be with us. You are our special guest at the Living in Holiness Chapel of the Lord's House of Prayer Intercessory Ministries. Fervently desire that while you're with us, you will encounter the presence of the Holy Spirit of Jesus Christ, our Lord Christ. The inspiration of the Holy Spirit and the love of God's children. These important elements we meticulously cultivate and allow to flourish. Come in again, much as you like to study with us and to hear the Word of God. And thank you for making this place a study. Did you know that God loves you? He always has, He always will. He offers you eternal life. I want to close all this today. I want to encourage you to start learning the fruits of the Spirit to help you build your life so others can see the fruit of the Spirit grow in you through Christ. The first three are very important, but the rest aren't. There are nine altogether. Love, joy, and peace. Once you've got them three down, the rest will follow in. Patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are the nine fruits of the Spirit. Not everybody has every one of them, but most people have most of them. But I will say to you, it's good to have patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. But I think it's very important, the first three in the fruits of the Spirit, love, joy, and peace, should be very important to all the rest of us. Without love, you can't love one another. Without joy, you can't jump for God and give Him praises. Without peace, you can't live a life. So, thank you, and may the Lord be with you and have His hand of favor upon you today. May you be blessed in the name of Jesus, I pray. This is Reverend Raymond. Have a good night and sleep well, and may the blessings of Jesus be on you. Amen.